Can a book save your life? That's not metaphorical, that's reality. At Electric Literature, we're serious about books. We're also serious about keeping you safe. So we posed a question. Of all the big books that came out in 2010, which would be the most likely to protect you in the event of a shooting? John, you ready?
Let's go for it.
Let's shoot some books. Okay, let's see how some of these books fared. We've got David Mitchell's new novel here. Looks like it's actually pretty clean here, but if you notice, one went clean through and really destroyed the back end, so I'm not gonna live with that one. Jonathan Franzen, my wife loves this guy. He refused to go on Oprah. Now she's given him a book award, but look. You're still dead. Jonathan, though, he's still doing well, so. Kindle. Some people wondered how this would fare because it's kind of a, seems like a solid piece of equipment, but obviously look at that, clean right through. The only consolation is you're gonna die quickly with a Kindle. The Four Fingers of Death, an apropos title from Rick Moody, a friend of Electric Literature, but sorry, Rick, your novel did not protect us. The Instructions, Adam Levin. Now this I had high hopes for. Look at the size of this book. And it's in hardcover. I mean, it's a hefty book. But no, look at this. Not good. This is McSweeney's readers. They're reading this in bad neighborhoods. It should protect you from a gun. You hear me, Dave? Now this is a surprise. Paperback novel by Joshua Cohen. Vitz is the title. Look at this. Almost intact. The bullet went in. It did... Oh, look, there's pieces of bullets in the book. Look at this. Something came out the back here, but if it didn't stop the bullet, it did slow it down. So, the most protective book of 2010, Vitz.